masonry work. I put the photo there at the front. It is a technique, it does work. I used it for maybe 5 hours today and it cleared off a whole section, and so it's kind of nice that it worked. It's very laborious though, and it's not easy. It is easy, it's an easy, simple solution, it's just the strenuous of it. Okay, so you take the pickaxe, you have a pickaxe, a board, you can use a 2x4, and then you hammer with them like a mallet through underneath that concrete slab. Now, normally, before I did all that hammering, I dug around, I cleared at least maybe a good section underneath, so made a ledge for that 2x4, and then you stand on the 2x4, okay, and then you just try to push it down with all your weight, and you try to let it heave a little, let the slab heave. And no, it doesn't. If you've got a hard, tough aggregate, it is not going to crack at that moment. It might take a section, like maybe a section of a 3x4 or a 3x3 section. It may take that whole section and cut it off on those edges. And you may actually find that it's lifting like a massive slab. But that's still no good, because that's not movable. Okay, so what you have to do is, now that you have, you're standing on the 2x4, or you're near the 2x4 that's wedged under. Now, I did not stand on the 2x4 when I swung the sledgehammer. You have to have a sledgehammer for the next part of the act. Now you take the sledgehammer and you just whirl it down again and again and again in the same spot. Now, it has to go about 6 inches to a foot from where that board is underneath the slab. So you have to have it near that board area, because apparently it's created some kind of a weird bounce or a crack zone, okay? So, and then you just keep hitting that, and sometimes one section, maybe I had to hit 20 times or more, so it's very, very terrible. And then when it cracks, it'll crack all different ways. It won't be clean. Also, I failed to mention that before all of this occurs, the easiest, before you start doing the dig under and all of that, take off the top tiles with a small chisel and a hammer. Take off those and wear goggles the entire time. You have to take off the top tiles, because for some reason the grout that they use is really tough, and it makes the second part of the act of the sledgehammer even worse, because when those fly, those little ceramic tiles fly, they can fly into your eyes, your hair, whatever. They're gonna really hurt, so don't do it that way. Okay, so now it's all dug out. You put in like this board underneath. You slammed at it. It's cracked. Now, if you have chunks that are too big, too large, you move them on, just right back onto the slab, on an angle, an open angle, and then just smack through them again. Go drunk, and so you might end up with 2 pieces or 3 pieces out of that larger one that's broken up, and then you can deal with it. So that's the process. Anyway, it was a terrible day, absolutely terrible day, you know. And the demands of one moment, it just became, while all of this is going on, I'm just trying to crack at this slab and get it to clear out, because it was a huge area and it was a really tough mean aggregate with stones in it. So somehow those stones were really tight with that particular concrete. I don't know if it was plasticizer they used or what, but it was not breaking up. So, whereas I had another section with the sand, and just a little bit of the mortar or the concrete, and that aggregate breaks up right away. It only needs a couple of the wax, but same thickness, and yet one was more like a sandstone. So that mix, I recommend using that sort of mix, because it still was flat like the other. I don't see why you have to have such a tough, heavy foundation style on a pathway. You should never need a foundation style. You just need a good one that you know holds whatever level. I don't know. I think they just went too far on this particular one. So anyway, I shall show the photo, and then I did it. I cleared it all out. It was like 5 hours, and I fought all day at the same time. It was just terrible. Anyway, so I'm not going to any funeral events. Don't worry. I did find out, because I was like, well, should I get a restraining order? Because there's a person in this couple, there's two people actually in Texas that I really despise. And I'm like, well, should I get restraining orders? Because I don't want them near me. That process is not as fun as I thought. It's not as quick. And so instead, I'm going to go with the personal property. Anyone who tries to rob your personal property is a thief, and therefore classed as, and so you have the right to kill them on your property. Okay, so there is that. So I am justified with anybody who is a thief that I can kill them. So that's Texas. So those two people, who are both thieves, by the way, one tried to steal my car, and the other one just tried to steal just my money. That we have two of those, and then I'm gonna be like, well, I guess I have that. I can go ahead and I'm justified. Okay, so there's Texas. Not all states are property theft. You have the right. Not all states. So you'd have to look up yours before you start running around grabbing your guns and your, what am I going to kill the bastards with? Yeah, before you get all of that excitement, you have to find out about your state. Because some states it's only self-defense reasons, and other states if you try to steal my item, you're a goner legally. So that's kind of good where I am right now. What else happened? It was just a terrible. When you're going through this much, and I don't like getting into fights in the middle of this type of masonry work, and I don't know if anybody has gone through fights and masonry work at the same time, but sometimes people do that. You know, we have this conflict. One says, I don't want you to work so hard, you know, but then that stops, and then all of a sudden other things start showing up, and how much can I throw at her face to interrupt her and disturb her, to stop her from working, and then, yeah, I just can't take it, and I'm like, that's it, I cannot stand pretty much anybody anymore, I am just furious. And you don't need that furious state in order to hit the masonry rock and stone. I think I'm like 5'1" tall. I don't need that furious state. However, it does help, I guess. It does help sometimes make a person angry, to make them do the work that's very arduous. But I don't like that methodology. I think it's terrible. I mean, it's gotten me to the point where I'm like, well, I think I need to change my name because of these two harassers. I need to change my name, like legally, and get ready to leave the United States permanently because of their harassment. Their harassment push, all as long, well, not all of them, not both of those people, just one of them has been harassment pushing me ever since I landed here on U.S. soil about 4 years ago. So that harassment pusher has got me to the point where I'm like, I have to change my name and disappear, never be found type of thing. I looked up that procedure, and that one is not so great. That one is not so great either, because you have to go through the Social Security Admin Administration, change your name, that's fine, but then you have to change everything else. You have to change your banks, you have to change your... I'm not certain if you can get a brand new Social Security number, because chances are this particular woman who has been hounding me all of these years, she knows my Social Security number. So I'm afraid that if I move myself off to wherever, you know, Honduras, she will try to locate me even there and continue with her harassment, you know. So I have like this constant hell that's following me, this person, and I can't make her stop. And I don't understand, because I never even did anything to her, ever. And yet, she manipulates my brother, and he manipulates his brothers, and so I have no friends, all because of this woman. And I'm just like, well, anyway, so that's on the burner, you know, if I change my name entirely and I'll leave the United States permanently after my dad dies. So anyway, nice family, huh? I've got a nice family like hell. And anyway, so that's masonry work, and I really don't like Catholics at all. And there was one girl I liked from ballet once, and she was a Catholic, and she's a Catholic now, and she's pretty strict at it. I don't mean to say I don't like you or whatever, but I don't know. I just get the feeling this little club knit thing is so aggressive that I don't know, I don't feel welcome in that, anywhere near the fold. So yeah, so happily, I'm not, I don't know, what am I saying? I don't have to deal with the Catholic group tomorrow, because it will be a Catholic group, and that's kind of sick. It's a sick round out that, I don't know, I think you guys, wrong, so, anyway, my, I told my uncle, I'll see the others maybe around town sometime, you know, say hi, but not tomorrow, okay, because I'm thinking about that personal protection law where I can kill the person if they enter this property or get near it. So he better stay the hell away. And that's the way it goes. Next, Dambria is where, you know, where do I go? What country on this planet do I go to live as a disappear act? Where do I go? That's all.